الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Clostridial myonecrosis or gas gangrene by Professor محمود هاني سليمان. Etiology: Clostridial myonecrosis due to Clostridium species, most often Clostridium perfringens. Organisms are large gram-positive spore-forming anaerobic bacilli with blunt ends. Other Clostridia may be involved. Epidemiology: Clostridial myonecrosis due to contamination of open wounds involving muscle. Sources of Clostridium species are soil, contaminated foreign bodies, human and animal feces, dirty surgical or traumatic wounds, particularly those with retained foreign bodies or significant amounts of devitalized tissue predispose to disease. Epidemiology 2, non-traumatic gas gangrene occurs rarely in immunocompromised people and most often in those with underlying malignancy, neutrophil dysfunction, or disease associated with bowel ischemia. Pathology, which is important. Disease manifestations due to potent clostridial exotoxin, e.g. C. sordelli with medical abortion and C. septicum with malignancy. Mixed infection with other gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria is common. The incubation period from time of injury is 1 to 4 days. Diagnostic test: anaerobic cultures of wound exudate or involved soft tissue, not swab, or muscle and blood should be culture for them should be performed. Clostridium species recovery from a wound is not diagnostic unless typical clinical manifestations are present. Diagnostic test 2, important. A gram-stained smear of wound discharge showing gram-positive bacilli and few, if any, polymorphonuclear leukocytes suggest Clostridial infection in lab because some pathogenic Clostridium species are oxygen sensitive. Care taken to optimize anaerobic growth conditions. A radiograph of affected site can show gas in tissue, but it is non-specific finding and is not always present. Occasionally, blood cultures are positive and considered diagnostic. Clinical manifestations: disease onset preceded by acute pain at site of wound, followed by edema, increased severe tenderness, exudate, and progression of pain. Clinical manifestations 2. Systemic findings initially include tachycardia, disproportionate to degree of fever, pallor, cyanosis, sweat, hypotension, renal failure, leading to oliguria and toxic zones. Later, alterations in mental status. Crepitus is suggestive but not pathognomonic of Clostridia infection and is not always present. Clinical manifestations 3. Diagnosis is by symptoms and signs, including characteristic appearance of necrotic muscle at surgery. Untreated gas gangrene can lead to disseminated myonecrosis, suppurative visceral infection, septicemia, death in hours. Treatment: prompt and complete surgical excision of necrotic tissue and removal of foreign material is essential. Repeated surgical debridement may be done to ensure complete removal of all infected tissue. Vacuum-assisted wound closure can be used following multiple debridements. Treatment 2. Management of shock fluid and electrolyte imbalance, hemolytic anemia, and other complications is crucial. High dose penicillin G given intravenously. Treatment 3. Clindamycin, metronidazole, meropenem, ertapenem, and chloramphenicol are alternative drugs if penicillin allergy is present, or for treatment of polymicrobial infections. Combination of penicillin G and clindamycin superior to penicillin alone due to theoretical benefit of clindamycin inhibiting toxin synthesis. Hyperbaric oxygen may be beneficial, but efficacy data from adequately controlled clinical studies are not available. Isolation of hospitalized patient. Do standard precautions which are recommended. Prevention, proper care of wounds, prevention of hospital acquired infection. Control measures, early detection of cases, prompt and careful debridement, flushing of contaminated wounds, and removal of foreign material, penicillin G or clindamycin, used for prophylaxis in patients with grossly contaminated wounds, but efficacy is unknown.